what would you say is the main takeaway from the book of Jonah? Would it surprise you if I said I didn't think it had anything to do with a giant fish? I'm Mitch Kimbrell, one of the pastors at Christ Memorial Church, and today we're wrapping up our time in the book of Jonah with a look at Jonah chapter 3. So up till now, God has called this Hebrew prophet to go to the Assyrian capital of Nineveh, the capital of one of Israel's greatest enemies, and to preach to them to repent because of their wickedness. Jonah doesn't do this. He goes in the opposite direction, and God sends a storm to get this wayward prophet back on track. Jonah's thrown overboard so as to calm the storm, and a giant fish swallows Jonah up. He's in the belly of that fish 3 days and three nights before the Lord appoints the fish to vomit Jonah onto dry land. Jonah gets recommissioned by the Lord. Go to Nineveh and preach against them for their wickedness. And this time, Jonah does that. Listen to verses 4 and 5 of Jonah chapter 3. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's journey, and he called out, "Yet 40 days and Nineveh shall be overthrown." And the people of Nineveh believed God. They called for a fast and put on sackcloth, from the greatest of them to the least of them. Verse 10, when God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil way, God relented of the disaster that he had said he would do to them, and he did not do it. God's mercy extending not only to the Jews, of which Jonah was one, but now to the Gentiles, the hated Assyrians. This story of Gentiles receiving God's mercy prophesies of the Lord Jesus Christ, who we're told in 1 John chapter 2 is the propitiation, not for our sins only, John writes, that is, not only for the sins of Jews like John, but he's the propitiation for the whole world. That is, Jesus is the wrath-satisfying sacrifice, not just for Jews, but for Gentiles. That's everybody, for people from every tribe and language and people and nation, for sinners just like you. So, I'm calling on you to repent from your sins, as Jonah did to the Ninevites. Will you, like they did, listen to that call and turn from your sins and believe or keep believing on the Lord Jesus? He's the Savior not only of Hebrews, but for people all over the world. Believe in him.